Friesland. Friesland, official, also historically known as Frisia, is a province of the Netherlands located in the northern part of the country. It is situated west of Groningen, northwest of Drenthe and Overijssel, north of Flevoland, northeast of North Holland, and south of the Waddenzee. In 2015, the province had a population of 646,092 and a total area of. The capital and seat of the provincial government is the city of Leeuwarden, West Frisian, Leeuwart, a city with 91,817 inhabitants. Since 2017, Arno Brock is the king's commissioner in the province. A coalition of the Labour Party, the Christian Democratic Appeal, and the Frisian National Party forms the executive branch. The province is divided into 24 municipalities. The area of the province was once part of the ancient, larger region of Frisia. The official languages of Friesland are West Frisian and Dutch. In 1996, the states of Friesland resolved that the official name of the province should follow the West Frisian spelling rather than the Dutch spelling, resulting in Friesland being replaced by Friesland. In 2004, the Dutch government confirmed this resolution, putting in place a 3-year scheme to oversee name change and associated cultural program. The province of Friesland is occasionally referred to as Frisia by, amongst others, Hanno Brand, head of the History and Literature Department at the Friesk Academy since 2009. However, the English language webpage of the Friesland Provincial Council refers to the province as Friesland. The Frisii were among the migrating Germanic tribes that, following the breakup of Celtic Europe in the 4th century BC, settled along the North Sea. They came to control the area from roughly present-day Bremen to Brugge, and conquered many of the smaller offshore islands. What little is known of the Frisii is provided by a few Roman accounts, most of them military. Pliny the Elder said their lands were forest covered with tall trees growing up to the edge of the lakes. They lived by agriculture and raising cattle. In his Germania, Tacitus would describe all the Germanic peoples of the region as having elected kings with limited powers and influential military leaders who led by example rather than by authority. The people lived in spread-out settlements. He specifically noted the weakness of Germanic political hierarchies in reference to the Frisii, when he mentioned the names of two kings of the 1st century Frisii and added that they were kings as far as the Germans are under kings. In the 1st century BC, the Frisii halted a Roman advance and thus managed to maintain their independence. Some or all of the Frisii may have joined into the Frankish and Saxon peoples in late Roman times, but they would retain a separate identity in Roman eyes until at least 296, when they were forcibly resettled as Latii, Roman-era serfs, and thereafter disappear from recorded history. Their tentative existence in the 4th century is confirmed by archaeological discovery of a type of earthenware unique to 4th century Frisia, called Terptritsum, showing that an unknown number of Frisii were resettled in Flanders and Kent, likely as Latii under the aforementioned Roman coercion. The lands of the Frisii were largely abandoned by circa 400 due to migration wars, climatic deterioration and flooding caused by sea level rise. The area lay empty for one or two centuries, when changing environmental and political conditions made the region habitable again. At that time, during the migration period, New Frisians, probably descended from a merging of Angles, Saxons, Jutes and Frisii, repopulated the coastal regions. These Frisians consisted of tribes with loose bonds, centered on war bands but without great power. The earliest Frisian records name 4 social classes, the Ethelings, Nobiles in Latin documents, and Frilings, who together made up the free Frisians who might bring suit at court, and the Latin or Litten with the slaves, who were absorbed into the Latin during the early Middle Ages, as slavery was not so much formally abolished, as evaporated. The Latin were tenants of lands they did not own and might be tied to it in the manner of serfs, but in later times might buy their freedom. Under the rule of King Albgisel, the Frisians came in conflict with the Frankish mayor of the Palace of Bruin, over the old Roman border fortifications. Albgisel could keep the Franks at a distance with his army. During the reign of Redbad, however, the tide turned in favor of the Franks. In 690, the Franks were victorious in the Battle of Dorestad. In 733, Charles Martel sent an army against the Frisians. The Frisian army was pushed back to Eastergoa. The next year the Battle of the Boyne took place. Charles ferried an army across the Alamera with a fleet that enabled him to sail up to the Boyne. The Frisians were defeated in the ensuing battle, and their last king Popo was killed. The victors began plundering and burning heathen sanctuaries. Charles Martel returned with much loot, and broke the power of the Frisian kings for good. The Franks annexed the Frisian lands between the Vlie and the Loires. They conquered the area east of the Loires in 785, when Charlemagne defeated Wedukind. The Carolingians laid Frisia under the rule of Gruen, a title that has been loosely related to count in its early sense of governor rather than feudal overlord. About 100,000 Dutch drowned in a flood in 1228. When, around 800, the Scandinavian Vikings first attacked Frisia, which was still under Carolingian rule, the Frisians were released from military service on foreign territory in order to be able to defend themselves against the heathen Vikings. With their victory in the Battle of Nordidi in 884, they were able to drift Vikings permanently out of East Frisia, although it remained under constant threat. Over the centuries, whilst feudal lords reigned in the rest of Europe, no aristocratic structures emerged in Frisia. This Frisian freedom was represented abroad by Rijeven, who were elected from among the wealthier farmers or from elected representatives of the autonomous rural municipalities. Originally, the Rijeven were all judges, so-called assega, who were appointed by the territorial lords. After significant territories were lost to Holland in the Friso-Hollandic Wars, Frisia saw an economic downturn in the mid-14th century, accompanied by a decline in monasteries and other communal institutions. Social discord led to the emergence of untitled nobles called Hodlingen, headmen, wealthy landowners possessing large tracts of land and fortified homes who took over the role of the judiciary as well, offering protection to their local inhabitants. Internal struggles between regional leaders resulted in bloody conflicts and the alignment of regions along two opposing parties, the Feetkeepers and Skieringers. On March 21, 1498, a small group of Skieringers from Westergo secretly met with Albert III, Duke of Saxony, the governor of the Habsburg Netherlands, in Medemblik, requesting his help. Albrecht, who had gained a reputation as a formidable military commander, accepted and soon conquered all Friesland. Emperor Maximilian of Habsburg appointed Albrecht hereditary potestate and governator of Friesland in 1499. In 1515, an army of peasant rebels and mercenaries known as the Aremers Varda Hoop started a peasants' revolt against the Habsburg authorities. The leader was the farmer Pier Gerlof Stanya, whose farm had been burned down and whose kinfolk had been killed by a marauding Lanzknecht regiment. Since the regiment had been employed by the Habsburg authorities to suppress the civil war of the Feetkeepers and Skieringers, Stanya put the blame on the authorities. After this, he gathered angry peasants and some petty noblemen from Frisia and Gelderland and formed the Aremers Varda Hoop. The rebels received financial support from Charles II, Duke of Gelders, who claimed the Duchy of Gelders in opposition to the House of Habsburg. Charles also employed mercenaries under command of his military commander Martin van Rossum in their support. However, when the tides turned against the rebels after the Donya's death in 1520, Charles withdrew his support, without which the rebels could no longer afford to pay their mercenary army. The revolt was put to an end in 1523 and Frisia was incorporated into the Habsburg Netherlands, bringing an end to the Frisian freedom. Charles V, the Holy Roman Emperor, became the first lord of the Lordship of Frisia. He appointed Georg Schenk van Toutenberg, who had crushed the peasants' revolt, as stadtholder to rule over the province in his stead. When Charles abdicated in 1556, Frisia was inherited by Philip II of Spain along with the rest of Netherlands. In 1566, Frisia joined the Dutch revolt against Spanish rule. In 1577, George de Lauwing, Count of Rennenberg, was appointed stadtholder of Frisia and other provinces. A moderate, trusted by both sides, he tried to reconcile the rebels with the crown. But in 1580, Rennenberg declared for Spain. The states of Frisia raised troops and took his strongholds of Leeuwarden, Harlingen, and Stavoren. Rennenberg was deposed and Frisia became the fifth lordship to join the rebels' Union of Utrecht. From 1580 onward, all stadtholders were members of the House of Orange-Nassau. With the Peace of Munster in 1648, Frisia became a full member of the independent Dutch Republic. In 1798, 3 years after the Batavian Revolution, the lordship of Frisia was abolished and its territory was divided between the Eems and Overijssel departments. This was short-lived, however, as Frisia was revived as a department in 1802. When the Netherlands were annexed by the First French Empire in 1810, the department was renamed Frisé. After Napoleon was defeated in 1813 and a new constitution was introduced in 1814, Friesland became a province of the Sovereign Principality of the United Netherlands, then of the Unitary Kingdom of the Netherlands a year later. Friesland is situated in the northwest of the Netherlands, west of the province of Groningen, northwest of Drenthe and Overijssel, north of Flevoland, northeast of the IJsselmeer in North Holland, and south of the North Sea. It is the largest province of the Netherlands if one includes areas of water. In terms of land area only, it is the third largest province. Most of Friesland is on the mainland, but it also includes a number of West Frisian islands, including Vlieland, Terschelling, Ameland, and Schiermonnikoog, which are connected to the mainland by ferry. The province's highest point is at above sea level, on the island of Vlieland. There are four national parks of the Netherlands located in Friesland: Schiermonnikoog, De Aldevenen, Laersmeer, partially in Groningen, and Drents Fries Wold, also partially situated in Drenthe. The 10 urban areas in Friesland with the largest population are. The province is divided into 24 municipalities, each with local government, municipal council, mayor and aldermen. The province of Friesland has an oceanic climate, Köppen climate classification, CFB. In 2010, Friesland had a population of 646,305 and a population density of. The years 1880 to 1900 show slower population growth due to a farm crisis during which some 20,000 Frisians emigrated to the United States. Since the late Middle Ages, Friesland has been renowned for the exceptional height of its inhabitants, who were deemed among the tallest groups of Indo-Europeans. Even early Renaissance poet Dante Alighieri refers to the height of Frisians in his Divine Comedy when, in the Canticle about Hell, he talks about the magnitude of an infernal demon by stating that not even three tall Frieslanders, were they set one upon the other, would have matched his height. Friesland is mainly an agricultural province. The black and white Frisian cattle, black and white stabihoon and the black Frisian horse originated here. Tourism is another important source of income. The principal tourist destinations include the lakes in the southwest of the province and the islands in the Wadden Sea to the north. There are 195 windmills in the province of Friesland, out of a total of about 1,200 in the entire country. Friesland is the only one of the 12 provinces of the Netherlands to have its own language that is recognized as such, West Frisian. According to a study carried out in 2007, West Frisian is the native language of the 54.3% of the inhabitants of the province of Friesland, then Dutch with 34.7%. Then people who speak other regional languages of the Netherlands with 9.7%, and then other languages with 1.4%. Frisian speakers were less present in urban areas, while they were predominant in less dense municipalities. West Frisian is also spoken in a small adjacent part of the province of Groningen, to the east. Closely related languages are spoken in nearby areas of Germany. They are East Frisian, Seelturk, which is different from East Frisian, Ostfriesisch, and is spoken in the Saterland, and a collection of Low German dialects off East Frisia, and North Frisian, spoken in North Friesland. These languages are also closely related to modern English. In Stellingwerf, in southeast Friesland, a dialect of Low Saxon is spoken. The language policy in Friesland is preservation. West Frisian is a mandatory subject in Friesland in primary and secondary schools. There are many bilingual and trilingual primary schools in the province of Friesland which use West Frisian as a language of instruction besides Dutch and modern English, but no secondary schools that include West Frisian as a language of instruction. The number of Frisian speakers who are able to write in Frisian is estimated at only 12%. The provincial government takes various initiatives to preserve the West Frisian language. All parents in Friesland are provided with information about the language and multilingualism at children's birth, ex-Taltaska. The province also invests in the development of speech pathology materials and strives to create information technology devices for the West Frisian language. The Frisian government subsidizes the AFUK organization, which offers language courses and actively promotes Frisian in all sectors of society as well as the corporate domain which is currently dominated by Dutch and modern English. The province also promotes a wide range of art and entertainment in Frisian. The province is famous for its speed skaters, with mass participation in cross-country ice skating when weather conditions permit. When winters are cold enough to allow the freshwater canals to freeze hard, the province holds its traditional Elf State and Tocht, 11 cities tour, a ice skating tour. A traditional sport is Frisian handball. Another Frisian practice is Vierljeppen, a sport with some similarities to pole vaulting. A jump consists of an intense sprint to the pole, pole stuck, jumping and grabbing it, then climbing to the top while trying to control the pole's forward and lateral movements over a body of water and finishing with a graceful landing on a sandbed opposite to the starting point. Because of all the diverse skills required in Vierljeppen, Firejeppers are considered to be very complete athletes with superbly developed strength and coordination. In the warmer months, many Frisians practice wadlopen, the traditional art of wading across designated sections of the Waddan Sea at low tide. There are currently two top-level football clubs playing in Friesland, SC Cambuur from Leeuwarden, home stadium Cambuurstadion, and SC Heerenveen, home stadium Ablandstrasstadion. The King's Commissioner of Friesland is Arno Brock. The states of Friesland have 43 seats. The provincial executive is a coalition of the Christian Democratic Appeal, the People's Party for Freedom and Democracy, the Socialist Party and the Frisian National Party, FNP. Colspan equals 2 align equals left vertical bar party. Votes. Seats. Colspan equals 2 align equals left vertical bar total. 297,307 exclamation mark align equals center, 43. The four motorways in the province are A6, A7, E22, A31, and A32. The main railway station of Friesland is Leeuwarden, which connects the railways Arnhem-Leeuwarden, Harlingen-Nieuweschans, and Leeuwarden-Staveren, which are all, partially, located in the province. Ameland Airport near Balham and Dratten Airfield near Dratten are the two general aviation airports in the province. The Royal Netherlands Air Force uses Vlieland Heliport and the Leeuwarden Airbase. Friesk Dagblad and Leeuwarder Courant are daily newspapers mainly written in Dutch. Omroep Friesland is the public broadcaster with radio and TV programs mainly in Frisian. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.